Indaba is the largest tourism fair in Africa and it is organized every year in Durban, South Africa. This year, South Africa Tourism has given a special importance to the Indian market and planned to consecrate a significant part of its total advertising budget of nearly $8 million this year.
You know, clearly we know that outbound tourism from India worldwide, the numbers are growing. More and more Indians are traveling. So our challenge really is to get a greater share of it, and we think we've got a lot going for ourselves to get that share of it.
If you come to South Africa, we know that we'll give you the experiences, but we're saying here we've created a platform such as Indaba so that we actually showcase the world that this continent has all the experiences that our travelers are looking for.
One of the reasons government invests in tourism is because it's the quickest way to create a job. And when you look at the GCP study that we did in 2009, it told us exactly which levers we must pull to create a job. The Indian market is like a test case study. They enjoy adventure, they enjoy activities, they do a huge amount of activities. They buy double or triple the amount of activities than any other nation in the world coming to South Africa.
About 80,000 tourists visited South Africa last year. The ministry believes that if the strict visa regulations are made easier, the numbers could double in just a couple of years.
In many respects, we have made it easier for Indians to obtain a visa to travel to South Africa. By a particular difficulty that we are experiencing in India is the capacity to service those applications. So the challenge for us is to get more people there to help process those visa applications.
And there has been a move to create a forum of African ministers to actually put a case forward to say, this is what we want to promote, inter-Africa travel. How do we then put together policies and legislation which would actually govern and assist with the ease of travel, especially if someone is already in the continent?
India and South Africa have a lot of common points, including the melting pot factor. It is also where the Mahatma Gandhi lived for many years before returning to India for the freedom fight.
I mean, one is we do have the melting pot of cultures, and clearly there's an element of Indian travelers feeling very much at home in South Africa. Very big Indian population, in particular a population of people of Indian origin here in Durban. You know, in many ways there are cultural similarities. Like if you go to Mumbai and there really is no issue on the ground whether you're Muslim or Hindu. You know, people blend and they mix with each other. And so there's that kind of mixing that you have in India in any event. And the Indian population in South Africa is exactly the same.
Another peculiarity of the Indian travelers is that they always prefer to have Indian food as well as vegetarian options. South Africa being home to an important Indian diaspora, the curries are part of the everyday cuisine.
Take an Indian traveler, a couple of days not eating spicy food and they go nuts. So sooner or later you've got, and we have fantastic Indian cuisine as well, not just in Durban, all over the country.
In India we have the tigers, but in South Africa we have the lions. Safaris and adventure activities are the best seller of South Africa tourism.
Tigers remain a very threatened species. So it's good news to know that the tiger population is increasing, but it is small in number. It is difficult to go and see a tiger in India, although they're there. It is very easy to see a lion in South Africa. You go to the Kruger National Park, you're going to see a lion.
Adventure in South Africa is one of our best sellers. Indians are one of our biggest buyers, and it's led by Indian women. So we have more Indian women that jump low cross bungee. We have more Indian women than men that do shark edge driving. We have more Indian women than men that do the abseiling of Cape Town. So as a woman, that's quite nice for me, you know, that Indian adventure out of India is pushed specifically by women.
For many Indians, South Africa is also perceived as an elite and expensive destination. South Africa Tourism has developed alternative options in three stars or guest houses for the middle class travelers.
So you're looking for something that is a bit more affordable. Yeah. That actually we do have. That actually distinguishes us from other countries offering safari experiences. In every city, in just about every town and almost every village, there are really good guest houses that are quite affordable.
The travel is for everyone. And the country and the products that and experiences which exist in the country is meant for everyone and not just for the elite.
Another concern about South Africa is the popular perceptions that parts of the country are unsafe.
The issue around safety of tourists as well has now, you know, come to the top of the agenda, because tourism has now been identified as one sector that can help grow the economy. So we have taken major steps in terms of educating trade. And the fact that we do FEM trips is to expose people to, it is not bad, it is perception.
In terms of campaigns this year, we are launching a brand spanking new global campaign on the 1st of September. So we're incredibly excited about it, and guess who will be the first market to put it out? India. So we're very, very excited. You'll be, guys, be the first to see the new global campaign.
Tourism from India to South Africa is certainly growing, but there are also challenges, and it will take at least a few years before South Africa and the entire continent recovers from the scars left by Ebola epidemic. Recently, South African Airways, facing a shortage of aircraft, stopped the only direct flight from Mumbai to South Africa. Nevertheless, South Africa and its amazing landscapes, wildlife and people will definitely thrill the adventure lovers.